Hey, what is going on, my friends, and welcome back to another video on the My Stock Journey channel. So today we are talking about brokerages. So a lot of you are asking me, if you took notice, in a lot of probably my honestly like three or four videos that I was showing you guys stocks that I had in both Robinhood and M1 Finance, and you were curious, why did you sell out of M1 Finance and go to Robinhood? Do you prefer one of the other, etc., etc.? So today I wanted to talk about why I personally prefer Robinhood over M1 Finance. So I will give you guys a little backstory. So whenever I first got started investing, it was either Robinhood or M1 Finance, right? Those were the two in my head that kind of like appealed to me the most. This was also before Robinhood's most recent update that added a lot of new features. But what I took notice of the most was the fact that M1 Finance allowed you to buy in fractional shares. So at the time, I was a lot more conservative. I was a lot more nervous about everything. I had never really known anything about the stock market. And so I was like, well, I'll probably choose M1 Finance because I like the fact that I can buy fractional shares. I can invest less money, get these companies that I want, et cetera, right? Well, so as time went on, you know, I had my M1 Finance account. And one thing that I was not liking that much was the fact that I couldn't really control the price that I bought the stock at. And what I mean by that is the fact that whenever I was buying stocks, you put in the amount of money that you want to spend on that stock, right? So say if I want to get a share of Microsoft, it's $170, $160 roughly, right? Well, I can put in that I want to buy $30 worth of the stock of what at whatever price it's at right now. And you know, the stock market does this, right? And it's very hard. M1 Finance doesn't update as fast as Robinhood does, so you can't really tell exactly what price you're buying it at. At the time when I first started investing, it didn't really matter all that much, simply for the fact that I was just getting my feet wet. I was just trying to figure it all out. I didn't really understand the fact that how much, you know, a 25 cent difference in market price could affect how much money I'm making overall, right? I didn't understand that if I had 40 shares and I bought it at 25 cents less, I can make $10, right? $10 if it goes up that 25 cents. But so as time went on, I started to realize, man, if I was buying in at certain prices that I could set, that I could see, then I could be making a little bit, $40 extra here, $20 extra here. And that starts to add up. And as I started to get a little bit more experience in the market, that's when I started to take notice that that's important. Secondly, I was interested in Bitcoin. I was interested in crypto, and I was, you know, interested in all these different fields of potential investments. M1 Finance only really allows you to invest in these, how do you explain it? The ordinary, the traditional stocks, your big normal on the market companies, right? I was interested in these other cryptos, and it's something I've been getting my feet wet in recently, and I couldn't do that through M1 Finance. So that kind of made it harder because, I don't know, I felt like I was kind of limited to what I could trade, and I wasn't really a big fan of that. Thirdly, why did I switch over to Robinhood? This was another big one. I could watch the bar and I could watch the number change as the day was going on, because I was getting to the point that, look, I knew this stock was gonna go down because I had some bad news, but its earnings were the next week and I knew the earnings were gonna do good. So I was like, well, it's gonna go down right here. I'm gonna buy in and then I'm gonna, you know, wait, I'm gonna swing trade it, sell out, boom, done. That's really, really hard to do on M1 Finance, simply for the fact that you can't control what you're buying it at. So somebody could be selling theirs at 26, it goes down to 25, but you bought at 26 within 30 seconds. You know what I mean? And so that does make it really hard. So when it comes to like the technical stuff, I'm a bigger fan of Robinhood just because I have more control over the price and, you know, everything I'm buying at there. Second, the next reason, the next big topic, is, you know, just overall appeal. I feel like M1 Finance is, people might hate on me for this one, but I feel like M1 Finance is just kind of boring. Just, you know, the overall look is kind of boring. It's super bland. Yeah, it has some cool little pie charts, but I mean, you know what I mean? That is a cool factor that you can kind of, I don't know, separate your portfolio in a certain percentage of pies. And if you just want to invest a bunch of money into that pie, it'll split the money up amongst all those. That's awesome. But for me personally, certain stocks appeal to me at certain times differently than others do. So if I only want to buy a little bit of Stag Industrial here because I know it's going to be low, I'll swing trade it up. I don't want to invest into that pie on M1 Finance 3 days later and my average cost on Stag Industrial rises. Like, it's not really for me. Personally, I thought it would be, but it's honestly not. But whenever it comes to appeal, I just feel like Robinhood's more of a user-friendly interactive app that gives you more of an experience, more of a fun experience whenever you're on the app, rather than M1 Finance is like straight to the point, like, okay, buy, sell, boom, boom, boom. You know what I mean? When you go to Bitcoin, it's such a retro, cool Tron look, and it gives you more of like, oh, this is cool, it's the crypto market, I'm like a hacker, you know what I mean? It gives you those type of feelings, and it just makes it much more of an overall enjoyable experience. And third is something that I didn't even really know about until I got onto Robinhood, and that's like the trade options and doing all that. Whenever you're using trade options, it's something I do here and there. I try to make a little extra $20 here, $10 here, stuff like that, and I've been pretty good, and I've won on about 5, lost on about 3 or something like that. I made like a total profit of like $60, I think. But hey, $60, I mean, I work at a mall, right? And I make like $60 is going to take me a lot longer than sitting here for 15 minutes. Boom, $60, bam, I'm out. I'm done. Boom, done. Right? So whenever it comes to that as well, Robinhood is such a more convenient way to be able to use those trade options and do all those things. And, you know, I just feel like overall, Robinhood, especially for someone my age, gives you so much more access to stuff that I need to see. You know, if I'm a bit of an older investor and I'm just, honestly, I have 3 stocks. I have the VOO, I have Microsoft, and I have a high dividend stock, right? And if I'm in my 40s, 50s, and I know I'm not going to buy anything else, I just want those, I don't care what they're at, I'm just going to keep investing money, yeah, I'm sure M1 Finance is perfect. But as someone who's just getting into the market and someone who's just wanting to learn all this and watch the numbers and, you know, interact with all the cool little stuff and feel like I'm in Tron, that type of stuff, Robinhood is absolutely the way for me to go. And that's why I did sell all my stocks on M1 Finance and move over to Robinhood. I actually did that in February, which I knew I was high. I was up like $400. I was like, all right, I'm gonna just sell here. If it goes down, I'll buy back in. If not, I'll just wait. And somehow, some way, that just worked out for me. That was the absolute best decision I could have made at the time. The only one that I didn't wait on was Stag Industrial. I had $21.50 average cost on 70 or 63 and a half shares or something like that. And I was like, it's not going to reach that low again. I just don't believe it will. So I'm going to keep that. There's no point in wasting that potential profit margin. So, yeah. But so overall, my pick will be Robinhood. I just do believe Robinhood is a more user-friendly, interactive, enjoyable experience. It gives you a lot more data, a lot more statistics. The pro account, if you go Robinhood Gold, you actually get access to like spreadsheets, and you get things that show you like a business's moat, like how much basically their control over that their certain sector. So like if you're waste management, you have a pretty high moat because you're like the best of the best, basically, just in broad terms. But anyway, so I do believe Robinhood is the better of the two. Just for someone like me, I'm not saying it's not. I'm not dissing M1 Finance at all. I think M1 Finance is an amazing app. I just think Robinhood's better. And so that's why from now on, all of my investments will more than likely be through Robinhood. I was trying out Webull the other day. It wasn't for me. I just didn't like it as much as Robinhood. So like I said, from now on, Robinhood will be my account. It'll be the app that I use all the time. And yeah, so with that, that will be the end of the video. I did want to just sit here, talk to you guys. I know every time I pretty much get questions about anything, I had someone ask me the other day what I thought the future of Microsoft was. I applied to them there, and then I also uploaded it to my YouTube channel. It just gives me the knowledge of what some people want to see, what they need to know about or want to know about. And so it really encourages me to want to make a video and just, you know, do whatever I can to help you guys out, just with anything, you know what I mean? And it'll be really fun. Like, say if I say, what's the future of Microsoft now? And I go look back in 2 years from now, and I'll call it perfectly. That'd just be really awesome. But whenever it comes to stuff like this, anytime you guys ever want to know anything, if you're curious, if you're interested about stuff about me or stuff that you want to know about the market from my opinion, absolutely just let me know in the comment section. I upload videos almost once a day, maybe once or twice, maybe once every 2 days, something like that. And so, yeah, so with that being said, if you are new to the channel, you made it this far, you support me, and I thank you so much. Go ahead and drop a subscribe for me. It would help me out a lot. If you also like the video, it'll help me reach new audiences. And yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Peace.